do what you say, say what you'll do. It's about predictability. Stay tuned, we're going to learn about real-time Java.
We interrupt this program for an important bulletin.
Welcome to this edition of SDN Channel. Joining me today is Eric Bruno, systems engineer.
Nice to meet you.
So, real-time Java, I thought it's all about performance.
Well, that's a common misconception. I come across that all the time. It's really about having deterministic behavior from your application, in this case, your Java application, and getting predictability from your threads and reducing your latencies as much as possible.
So, okay, predictability is good. Now, when I'm writing my Java code, one of the things that I always ran across is I never knew when, you know, the garbage collector was going to come out. You know, I had to deal with the pauses. I didn't know when the pauses came out. You know, when is it going to happen? I ran, you know, performance analysis tools to figure it out. Can real-time Java help me with that?
That is one area that it's focused on. The garbage collector in standard Java can run at any time, can interrupt your code at any time, and run for any length of time. It's unpredictable. And with that alone, you can't build a real-time system. But that's not only it. With real-time Java, you also are able to specify Java thread priorities, so you can specify a very high priority thread in the system.
What type of applications are, you know, will benefit from this? Is this, you know, web applications? Is this, you know, trading platforms? What types of applications?
Any application that has a temporal correctness condition, or what we call a deadline, has to respond to a certain event by a certain deadline or time frame.
Okay, and, you know, give us some examples of people who've implemented some. You know, is this running, you know, the space, you know, the space center or the shuttle? You know, tell us some examples.
Right. So we have a bunch of licensees that we can't talk about, but there are a couple that we can. Reuters is one. They're building trading systems and real-time market feeds on real-time Java. And we also just recently signed up ITT, who's building a ground-based space object and debris tracking system with real-time Java.
So this is real-time systems all going
Absolutely.
On Java.
Yes.
So, you know, for a developer, do I have the full access to the entire SDK? Is it a subset? Do I have extra methods that I need to, or are there extra APIs for me to control the behavior or have my application be controlled?
Yes, so it's Java 1.5 compatible, so it's completely Java. There's no changes to the language, and you can run your existing code on this without a problem. It is an extra set of libraries and a different implementation of the VM.
Okay, and does this run, this new VM, or this real-time VM, does that run on, what architectures does it run on?
Okay, currently our released product runs on Solaris 10, on x86, also AMD x64, and Spark. We have in beta right now running on Linux. It has to be Linux with the latest kernel, such as SUSE's real-time Linux and Red Hat's MRG Linux.
Yeah, I would imagine, you know, the people who are developing that the kernel and the hotspot compiler, whatever the compiler is being used underneath, probably there's a lot of dependency on the underlying operating system to help facilitate some of that kind
Absolutely.
Of predictability.
That's right. So the operating system has to be POSIX real-time compliant for that to occur.
Okay. So you have some fancy screens up here with some graphics. Tell us what you just want to show us.
Okay, real quickly, this system simulates a limit order system where if you have a large holding of stock in a company, you might want to put an order in with a broker to sell that stock if it ever hits a certain value. So you bought it here, it's currently here, if it gets to that value again, let's say you want the broker to sell. The broker might implement that system for all their customers in Java. If a garbage collection event or some other system event occurred while they're watching a data feed.
Oh, you're going to lose a lot of money then.
They might miss a tick and they're going to lose money. They're going to have to honor the price with you and they're going to have a loss.
Right.
What we're going to do here is on standard Java, we're going to implement that system and run it on real-time Java and show the differences.
Okay.
All right. This graph is going to show a few things. I'm going to run the non-real-time version first. Every time you see a blue bar go by, that's a garbage collection event. We have a 1 millisecond time-critical loop that checks orders against the current market data. We measure the actual time through the loop, and we graph it here. A millisecond is down here, but unfortunately, we're spiking up here with these what we call outliers. So right away, you see you can't build a real-time system on standard Java because you cannot get predictable behavior from your thread.
So if it's predictable, I would see a straight...
You see a nice flat line almost right down here.
Okay.
So I'm going to start the data feed application, and when this is going to start trading occurring. And what we should see, doesn't always happen right, we should see that a loss of money will occur. Didn't happen this time because it's unpredictable the way the application runs.
Sure.
But what normally happens with this is you would lose money because your thread gets interrupted by garbage collection or something else in the system, and you miss a market tick. I'm going to run the real-time version, and you're going to see some key differences. So the code is the same. It's a different VM. It's running in a real-time thread, though. This thread has a higher priority than the garbage collector.
When you do things like that, do you ever have the possibility of, you know, your application actually running out of memory because the collector couldn't go out and mark and sweep and free up some memory?
Right, so we've built some things into the system to guard against that. But if you look at the graph here, this is running with the real-time VM. Garbage collection is still getting a chance to run. So the key thing is that it's not running when my code is running. And if my code has to run to respond to an event, it will interrupt the garbage collector. But most people, the way they write code, they have natural block points that allow the garbage collector time to run.
Right.
There are other mechanisms built into it to work in cases where the garbage collector gets starved.
Okay, and now we can see here, one of the things that you're showing off is this is a flat line.
That's right. So now that 1 millisecond loop is always a millisecond guaranteed, right down to the microsecond granularity in that case.
So for humans, flat lines aren't good, but for computers,
that's right.
We love it.
It equates to predictable behavior.
Hey, excellent. Thanks for joining us today.
Thank you.
Stay tuned. We learned a lot about real-time Java. See you next time.